Hold fire! Fire now! Wait for my signal. Shoot! Make ready! Make ready! Fire now! Wait for the signal! Open fire! Make ready! Shoot! Open fire. Make ready. Prepare yourselves. Open fire. Wait for my signal. Shoot! Fire! Wait for my signal. Open fire.
Is about to be taken!
Open fire! Prepare yourselves. Go! Wait for the signal. Go! Make ready! Hold fire! Go! Wait for my signal. Fire! Wait for my signal. Open fire. Prepare yourselves. Hold fire. Fire now. Wait for the signal. Make ready! Go! my signal.
Fire now!
Make ready!
Go! Fire now!
Hold fire!
Go!
Prepare yourselves!
Fire!
Prepare yourselves! Hold fire!
Fire!
Prepare yourselves. Prepare yourselves.
Fire!
Wait for the signal.
Fire!
Hold fire.
Open fire.
Hold fire.
Go.
It takes a true monster to do something like this. At least they're gone.
I should have struck when I had the chance. Do you know where Pitcairn could have gone?
Back into the withered bosom of the British, no doubt. So that he may regroup and plan his next atrocity.
I need to find him. Every day I wait, more will suffer.
Chin up, friend. Many who should have died today now live because of you.
And what of them?
We do the best we can with what we've got.
It is not enough.
It never is.
For the support of the glorious cause. I beg they will accept my most cordial thanks for this distinguished testimony of their approbation. But lest some unlucky event should happen, unfavorable to my reputation, I beg it may be remembered by every gentleman in the room that I, this day, declare with utmost sincerity, I do not think myself equal to the command I am honored with.
Truly, there is no man better suited to the task.
Sir, I beg leave to assure the Congress
that as no pecuniary consideration could have taken me to have accepted this arduous employment.
Do I know you?
I would not expect you to remember.
Come, Connor. There's someone I want you to meet.
I will keep an exact account of my expenses.
Sorry to pull you away
like
that, but
I doubt not they will discharge.
The last thing we need is the two of you coming to blows. Now, Connor, allow me to introduce you to our newly appointed Commander-in-Chief, George Washington.
Ah. So you're the one who saved Sam and John at Lexington.
It was the Patriots who did that. I merely lent support.
As humble as he is brave, we could use more men like you. I'm sorry, but if you'll excuse me, I should attend to Charles over there. He looks none too happy about being passed over for command. It was good to meet you, Connor.
Tell me you have news of Pitcairn.
I'm told he's taken shelter in Boston, where he's guarded by 1,000 redcoats. The only way you're gonna get at him is if we draw him out. Now, lucky for you, we're launching an offensive against the city in order to do just that. Israel Putnam has been given command of our forces. Present this to him, and he'll provide whatever aid you require. You'll find him at the encampment on Bunker Hill.
You have my thanks.
No need. It's the least I could do. Pitcairn's a dangerous man. The sooner we're rid of him, the better.
I would say the same of Charles Lee.
Now that's an altogether different beast. Let us leave it for another day. Best you head to Boston, Connor. Still here, are you?
I was just wondering, what happens now?
There's quite a lot to do. Commander Washington must determine when and where we'll strike next. And we need to get to work on our message.
Message?
We must contact the broadsheets at once. Ensure it's clear to everyone that it was the Loyalists who fired first in Lexington.
But no one knows who fired first.
Which is exactly why we must spread the news quickly. We'll determine public opinion.
This seems dishonest.
Perhaps, but so what? People must believe we acted in self-defense, else we've committed treason.
But you have.
Better to bow and scrape before a tyrant, then? Is that what you suggest?
No, of course not. No one should be denied freedom. And yet, to change the truth, it seems a dangerous road to travel.
Understand, Connor. This is a war fought not just on the battlefield, but within hearts and minds as well. There's nothing wrong with a bit of theater, especially if it saves lives.
Yağma. Yağma. Thank you. armor. Yama.
Come to buy or sell?
Yağma. So, what can I do for you, Mynheer?
Hold and state your... I'm looking for Israel Putnam.
On whose orders?
Samuel Adams.
Follow me.
This is not Bunker Hill.
Aye, it's Breach. There's been some disagreement as to where we should encamp.
Any news from Boston?
The Tories aren't moving. And any time we try to press them, we lose a dozen men. I think Putnam and the others plan to assemble artillery on these hills. A good shelling might make the Redcoats rethink their strategy.
And what of John Pitcairn?
That bastard's the cagiest of the bunch. He's appeared time to time to taunt us or send regards by way of cannon fire. It's all right, though. He'll have what's coming to him soon enough. Up ahead. You can't miss.
I don't care much for your excuses, General. We could be building on Bunker Hill.
Breed is closer to the city, but it is also closer to their artillery!
Our orders came from men so devoted.
For John Pitcairn. I was told you would be able to help me find him.
He's tucked away inside their city with no reason to leave. As long as that ship continues its assault, we'll never flush him out.
But if the ship was silenced...
Oh, then poor John might be forced to get off his arse and come forward.
I shall fly this flag to signal my success.
And I shall speak fondly of you at your funeral. Numbers, you say. Better weapons, better training. But I do not fear. And neither should you. For what they have in material, they lack in conviction and care. But not us. We have discipline. We have order. And most importantly, we have passion. We believe. So maintain vigilance, conserve your ammo, ensure a proper line of sight, and above all else, men, do not fire until you see the whites of their eyes. Dare. You did it.
That was quite a speech.
Lies, all of it, I'm afraid. Still, such words have carried us thus far.
And what of Pitcairn?
He's left Boston. As I said, he would. Set up camp on Molten Hill. There's no good way to get at him. Not with that maelstrom growing down below. I suppose you could circle around a bit, or wait for us to thin their ranks.
There is no time. I will have to chance a direct approach.
That's twice today you proposed the impossible.
I see no other choice.
Not because you're mad as a March hare, son.
I expect an apology on my return.